Hello friends, my name is Kailash Sharma. In this video, we will see how you can filter data in Excel using VBA. So here I have a sample employee data, and what I wanted to do is that I wanted to apply a filter. If I do a manual filter, then this is what I wanted to do. So for example, country as Japan and department. Like that. Okay. Now, the same thing we wanted to do using VBA, and we'll try to make it more dynamic in nature. So, let me remove this filter and then let's go to the coding window. So, currently we do not have any code. We will insert a module and we will write a procedure, sub procedure. So, public sub. And let's say filter data. And how we will do a filter is, the idea is that basically we will select the entire data. So our data is ranging up to 201 row number, but this can be dynamic. Sometime your data might be plus or minus few rows. So we'll try to make it more dynamic. So for that, we'll say sheet 1. Now, sheet 1, why we have written? The sheet name is sample data. But if you see here, the sheet, the code name of the sheet is sheet 1. So, sheet 1 is what we will use. And then, range. Now, our data range, including the header, starts from, we know the first position is A1, right? The first cell here. And the end cell is G. And if we go down, 201. So G201. So one way is that I can directly type it like G201. But since I wanted to make it more dynamic, I will not write it like this. Instead, I will get this using a special formula or a code, which is used range means the range which is currently in use. We know that the our data is ending in row number 201. So that is what is the use range and the row of that. Okay. So it should bring the row number 201 in this case. So that's how I am doing. So basically what we are doing right now is we have selected a range. Now on that, we need to apply the filter. We'll say auto filter. Now it needs two parameters. First is the field and the criteria. So what is our field? We wanted to apply the filter on column E, which is the fifth column, right? So our range starts from A. So E is the fifth column. So, or I'll supply 5. And the criteria, what you want to apply in the E column? I wanted to apply Japan. So I will type Japan. Okay, and let's try to run it from here. You see that? So the filter is applied. Now, if I remove it manually, if I want to apply something else, let's say Mali. So if I change it, it will work for the other also. Yeah, like that. Now, here, what we will now do is we will apply two filters. One is on the country, another is on department. So what I'll do is I'll simply copy paste the code and I will make it to column D. Same code, but instead of auto filter, now this time it would be 4 and the value, let's say 711, and I'll make it back to Japan. Let's try to run it. Even if we do a, instead of full run, let me try to use F8. Okay. So I'll do F8 through which we can debug the code also. So first I'll press F8 and the first filter is applied as you see. And when I click on it again, the second filter is also applied like that, right? That's how you can filter the Excel data using VBA code. Now let's try to make it further dynamic. First is we will try to apply this using a button on the sheet. So let me remove the all the filters and let me add a shape. So I'll go to insert and then illustrations and a sample shape, maybe this one. And we'll say apply filter. And we will attach our code. So I'll make it center like this. And right click, assign macro. Our macro should be here. So here I have selected. If I try to run it, you see it has come. But maybe we want to add one more code is to clear the filter. Or let's say before that, we will say that Japan and this, which I have applied a filter, it should not be hard coded. I wanted this to mention here. Let's say, I'll say country and then department. So country, I will put like here, Mali, and department 108. Now I want the code to pick the filters from here and instead of hard code. So what do I have to do? The country is coming from K6. So I'll go to the code and instead of Japan, I will say that on sheet 1 dot range A6 dot value. Okay. So this way, instead of directly typing, it will pick it from K6. Same way, department has to take from L6. So I will again copy paste. I'll save some time. I will copy paste this code and make it to L6. Let's go to the sheet again. And this time, if we apply, you see, it has applied what data we have given. Okay. There is also one problem in this code is it is not clearing the filter. If you see, I am manually clearing the filter. So we need to clear some filter also before the next filter is applied. To show that impact, let's move this, we'll make some space. So I will move this data somewhere below. Okay. And our filters are on top. And let's modify our code a little bit. So now it is not starting. Our data is not starting from A1. Instead, it is A9. So I will change it to A9. Okay. But the range K6 and L remains the same. K6 and L. So it should work. So it is filtering the data starting from row number 5. So somewhere it is not working the way we want it. Let's try to debug. So here, what we try to debug is, let's see what range it is picking. So A9, we know that it will pick from A9. And G, this is where we see a problem where it is returning 5 number. So this is not giving the right output that we were looking for. In our case, it should be somewhere 200 plus, right? Instead of this code, we will type something else. So we will use our other method through which we can get the same result that we were expecting. So our idea would be to pick a column which doesn't have blank. So for example, column A doesn't have blank user ID. Okay. So I will go to the end of this sheet and I'll press Control Up key. So I will reach to the end row of this range. So that is what I'm going to do. So I will stop this and I'll say sheet 1. And we can check it in the immediate window, which is majorly used for debugging of this kind of issues. And then range, we'll say, let's say A and 10,000. 10,000 is a max that we expect. So I will hard code this like this. And then, and the up. So basically, I am pressing Control Up. So this is the code for that. And where I reached? I reached to row number 209. And this is the code we will try to use. And let's see if it works or still gives an issue. Here, paste it. Okay. So to summarize it again, what I'm doing is I am going to A10,000 cell and pressing Control Up key and I'm getting which row I reached. And that is what we needed. Okay. Let's try to run it again. Yes, it worked as per expectation now. And if I change now to Japan, 170, will it work? It doesn't work, right? Now, why it doesn't work? The reason it doesn't work is that the filter was already applied and it is applying the second filter. So, the earlier filter Mali was already applied and it is trying to add one more. So, that's where the data is not found. Even if I add the correct value, it will not come. Okay. Now, how we can fix this issue? The solution is to clear the filter first before our code applies. That means we have to write one more code saying before the code filters the data, we need to remove the filters. False. Let's try to run it. Okay. And let's give a valid value. It was 711. Okay. Now, if we try to apply, it works. And let's pick one more value so that, and we know this value also exists. So, I'll just copy paste here so that we can see it is working. So, first applied. This time, I will say Mali and 108. So, if our code is first clearing the filter and then applying this filter, then our button should work this time. So, you see, it is working. And if you want to see it in debug mode, we can see it. I will put a debugger and play. And if I press F8, you see, it is first clearing the filter. That's what it is doing. And then it is first applying then it is applying the filter. I hope you like this video. Keep learning with us. Thank you very much.